U.S. winter storm, icy blast hits 200 million Americans. Like the video and subscribe. We will continue to bring you hot news every day. Some 200 million Americans are feeling the icy grip of a massive winter storm that has been linked to at least 12 deaths ahead of the holiday weekend. More than 1.5 million people lost power and thousands of flights were canceled on Friday. The vast storm extends more than 2,000 miles, 3,200 kilometers, from Texas to Quebec. A bomb cyclone, when atmospheric pressure plummets, has brought blizzard conditions to the Great Lakes on the U.S.-Canada border. In Canada, Ontario and Quebec were bearing the brunt of the Arctic blast, with power cut to hundreds of thousands. Much of the rest of the country, from British Columbia to Newfoundland, was under extreme cold and winter storm warnings. They fled south to escape winter. The storm still found them. How to stay safe in a winter storm? The U.S. National Weather Service, NWS, said its Friday map depicts one of the greatest extents of winter weather warnings and advisories ever. Temperatures in Elk Park, Montana, dropped to 50°F, 45°C, while the town of Hell, Michigan, has frozen over. It was 1°F, 17°C, in the snow-covered community on Friday night. Emily, a bartender at Smitty's Hell Saloon, told the BBC, "It's pretty cold here, but we're having a hell of a time." In South Dakota, snowed in Native Americans burned clothes for warmth after running out of fuel, said tribal officials. Heavy snowfall was forecast in areas of Pennsylvania and Michigan. Buffalo, New York, was expecting at least 35 in, 89 centimeters. More than 8 million people remained under blizzard warnings, said the NWS. Coastal flooding has been seen in New England, New York, and New Jersey. In the Pacific Northwest, some residents ice skated on frozen streets in Seattle and Portland. Even the usually milder southern states of Louisiana, Alabama, Florida and Georgia were experiencing hard freeze warnings. U.S. winter storm in pictures. What extreme cold does to a human. A number of the storm-related fatalities have involved road traffic accidents, including a 50-car pileup in Ohio that killed two motorists. Travel problems across the country were being exacerbated by a shortage of snowplow operators, with low pay rates being blamed. More than 5,600 U.S. flights were canceled on Friday, according to the tracking site FlightAware, as flyers battled to make it home for Christmas. By Friday night, 1 million customers had no electricity across the U.S., according to PowerOutage.us. Utilities throughout the Tennessee Valley were implementing rolling blackouts to save power. The NWS says more than 100 daily cold temperature records could be tied or broken over the next few days. Decades-old records have already been matched. Denver, Colorado, dropped to 24°F on Thursday, its lowest point since the 1990s. Craig McBrady, 34, who is originally from Scotland, but now lives in Denver, told the BBC, "It is colder than I have ever experienced." Wichita, Kansas, recorded its coldest wind chill, 32°F, since 2000. Nashville, Tennessee, saw its temperatures plunge to below zero for the first time in 26 years. Casper, Wyoming, set a new record low on Tuesday of 42°F. We hope the video was useful to you. Like the video and subscribe. We will continue to bring you hot news every day.